Hallelujah.
Lord, Lord, Prince of Peace, great I am.
My message today, I'll just turn it upside down. That's kind of what Jesus does to us anyway, doesn't he? This is March 15th, 2018.
25th.
Or 25th. There, I already got it wrong. That's okay. I'm here. Pastor asked me to preach, and I just confess. It's like, oh, Lord, 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 oh, Lordy, Lordy, Lordy. But I took the challenge by faith. It's where to walk by faith. And I had a message on my heart, but I'll be honest, Pastor, to put it down in words. But there's so many thoughts that came in my mind. The one scripture that came to me, just let my tongue be the pen of a ready writer.
Amen.
So some people do it one way, and some people just, you know, we all got to, thank God we don't all. We got gifts in the body, that's preaching, but we got diversity the way we can do it. So, Father, I just come before you today, Lord. We just lift you up. We just lift you up, the God, the Jesus, Lord, upon the throne today, Lord, upon our hearts, Father. We thank you, Lord, that we're even here today. We thank you, Lord, for the very breath that we have, that we can't even speak, that we're able to speak of your wonderful works today, Father. This is a day. This is a day to rejoice. You said rejoice always. And again, you tell us. Again, I say rejoice. Because it's the good news. When you came into this world, you brought good news when the angels first announced it. Good news. It's not bad news. We have a good end. And it's with you, Lord. We stick with you. Those that endure to the end, amen, shall be saved. So, Lord, help us to endure. That's our prayer.
Amen.
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 My message today, and it's called Behold the Lamb. A lot of things that we behold today and that take our attention. A lot of attractions out there. A lot of distractions. But the main thing is, we got to keep our eyes upon the Lamb of God.
Amen.
Because if we keep it on people, we'll fall short. The enemy could come in and say, how do you do that? Oh, I can keep on the eyes of the Lamb here.
Amen.
I'm so glad. I was raised in a church. And how you present the gospel to people is so important. When you don't have the understanding, and well, I was taught that we couldn't read a Bible and we were too dumb and ignorant, but actually we are all like sheep, kind of dumb and ignorant. The word says that we've all went astray. Sheep are the dumbest animals ever, and that's why we need somebody to show us the way, which we know Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
And so when I was presented Jesus for the first time, I was asked, do you know if you die today, if you go to heaven? Well, I really didn't, to be honest. I never had no assurance of that. I never had nothing. I do remember as a child, very young, I don't know how old I was, but I wasn't much of a dreamer. But one dream I do remember as a child, and I don't know if it was a dream or now, whether I was actually taken out of my body. I don't know. I was so young. But the Lord brought that to my mind yesterday, and he brought me with angels, and he brought me into the heavens, while I guess a child would see heavens, and brought me through the clouds. And I do remember this. I was given a white robe, and I know that white robe in heaven stands for the righteousness of God. Because our righteousness, it says, is all as filthy rags.
Amen.
And I will confess, how I received Jesus, I was more worried about the wrath, because we had a doctrine that we grew up. You always had to know which side of the scale you was on, how good you were or how bad you were, how good you were, how bad you were. And you never really had the assurance. You just didn't have the assurance. And it took a long time out of my life to get that doctrine out, because it's so important. We got children out there now. I just, I want to Bible about Moses' time, Jesus, they tried to get away, the Jews. We're all in peril right now. We are living in perilous times. There's Satan out there that wants to take us out, but we got a God that can keep us.
Amen.
He's a good shepherd. He's not only the Lamb of God, but he's the good shepherd that knows how to keep his sheep.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Because as I get older, where's my keys? Where's my phone? Where's my purse? Or can I even find anything in my purse? And I have to have a keeper. I know Tim's at, I was like, I don't know, I just know God keeps my stuff, it'll turn up. And I will find it. I will lose nothing. I will lose nothing.
That's right.
Yeah. I've earned this, paid wages on this, worked hard, I will lose nothing. And for the last few years, I can honestly say I have lost nothing.
Amen.
He knows how to keep you, he can keep your stuff. After trusting to keep your stuff, can you keep your money? Because he says we're to confess and that we have the mind of Christ.
Yes.
We have the mind of Christ. Well, today, back in the faith I was raised, they would have had palms and this and that, but this was the selecting of the Lamb Day. And they would select that lamb. They had to carefully inspect it.
Amen.
To make sure it was out, no blemish. No blemishes could be on it. Well,
amen.
Jesus was the only unblemished lamb.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm here to say we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. I've had to repent many times. I still have to repent of my sins.
Amen.
I can't say I'm the unblemished lamb. If I was, then, you know, it says in these last days, you know, there may be more saviors out there. People be following them. Oh, they're the Jesus talked about. They're this one that's going to say no. We've only had one. His name is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He came.
Amen.
He rose again. Not just got buried, but rose again. And he is glorified and sitting at the right hand of the Father today. And the good thing is, unlike us, he is the same today, yesterday, and forever.
Amen.
So we can stand when we put our trust in Jesus on the solid rock, because he don't move. Now, he's in the process of these last days, moving us, shaking us. Some things weren't necessarily evil. Some things weren't necessarily bad. But it's not for this season. It's not for this season. We're in a new season. We're in a new day. So you think, well, Lord, that wasn't bad. That wasn't, no, I'm not saying it was evil or bad. But what, where do you need to be for this season, for this hour, for this time? And I'm going to get into a story. And my pastor was saying, so I said, Pastor, it's part of my message, but we'll probably speak it a little bit different. So, the unblemished lamb, I'm just going to stick it here so you guys can keep beholding it. Don't look at me. I'm just a clay vessel. We came from dirt. Actually, the chemicals in our body shows that we came from dirt. We're made up of dirt. So this is just an earthen vessel. So I'm going to speak of the one who declared, and I'm going to go to John, and then I'm going to flip back to Samuel here. But John 1:23. And this was talking at John the Baptist. And he says, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness. He knew who he was. He knew his identity. And we need to know who we are in Christ Jesus, because our identity comes from him.
Amen.
Because he said very clearly, I am. He didn't say, well, I think I am, I don't know, just don't know. Well, he says, if you got wisdom, need wisdom, ask, he'll give it to you liberally, without partiality, without respect. You know, he don't care, poor, rich, got money, it doesn't matter to him. He just says, you have not because you've asked not. That's what the word says. But John the Baptist, he says, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Make straight the way of the Lord, as said the prophet Isaiah. And then I'm going to go down the Pharisees, that's the religious group. We always have the religious group with us. I was full of religion. Took me years. When you're raised under religious cloth and just, you had to do this, do that, and try to get it right, and be the good girl, and be this, and be that. And, you know, you just never knew where you, like I said, once again, hit that mark. And I always had the danger. Always had the danger. What? What if I'm not good enough? What if I'm not good enough? What if I'm not good enough? And so I've learned it's not about my goodness. It's about His goodness, the unblemished lamb, the only one that was ever good, the only one without sin, that never committed sin. He said there was no guile even in His mouth and no deceit. Sometimes we even speak deceitful words because we're not even lining up with the Word of God. And He says, how can two walk together unless they be agreed?
Amen.
So, in the Lamb's book here.
Amen.
Called
Amen.
The Book of Life. Amen. Or else we can speak death on ourselves.
That's right.
I was telling Pastor the other day. I was just confessing. I'm just tired. It's 60-hour days, 60-hour weeks in September. I'm just tired. So, one point just knowing something about somebody, just a little bit, not all their, I'm not talking about gossip and all this and that, got to know all your dirty laundry out there. Well, they need all the dirty laundry of everybody to help them. I wouldn't want mine. He's washed it away with that blood of Jesus Christ. He washed my sins away when he done that final sacrifice. He said it's final. And all we have to do is come to him on a daily basis and repent and say, Lord, I'm feeling dirt. He said, well, you know the remedy. And he will cleanse you. And that's as true today when he was on that cross and shed his blood for us. Because he said, where the blood is, there is life. He was a representation of that. Moses, when they came out, they had to put that blood on the doorpost. And that's on. That was
Amen.
The lamb. Back then, it was a lamb. That's the lamb. The precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Aren't you glad we don't have to come up here and make a bloody mess, Pastor?
Okay.
Now, I'm going to go, because I was glad you sung that song. Clean. We could be clean. Because I know there's many times I felt dirty in my life. I'm going to go to 2 Samuel 11. And it's the story of David. And David was a king. If you know Jesus Christ, we are kings and priests unto him.
Thank you, Lord.
So this message is for you. You say, well, I've never been a king. Yes, you are. You're in the body of Christ. He says, we are kings and priests unto him.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. And the good thing about this message, it ends up good. Romans 8:28. For we know all things
Amen.
Work together for good to love
Amen.
God.
Amen.
And called according to not our purposes, but his purpose.
Amen.
And that's why you need to know the season you're in, the time you're in, and the purpose. Nobody tell you the purpose. You got to find that out. Be like John the Baptist. I am. So know who you are and him. It's so important.
Amen.
I'm going to read. This is starting in chapter 11 in 2 Samuel, and it says, and it came to pass after the year was expired, at the time when kings go forth to battle, that David sent Joab and his servants with him and all Israel. And they destroyed the children of Ammon and besieged Rabbah. I may not say that right, but David tarried still at Jerusalem. The kings were to go with the people in battle. And we, as today, are kings that go in to the battle for other people. We are the ones that know Jesus Christ. We are the ones that stand in the gap.
Amen.
Not judging for their sins, but stand in the gap. And if you hear things about people, stand in the gap. You heard it in your ear, not to say, did you hear? Oh, did you hear? Did you hear? To stand in the gap.
Amen.
Amen.
David, I know as a king, I know he stood in the gap for many people. When he went out there, he used to take care of the sheep. He was a he took care of the sheep. He had to keep track of the sheep. And he was out there. He knew about the, if anybody knew about animal sacrifices, it had to be David. He was around those sheep all the time, and he knew about the animal sacrifices back then. He knew about the lamb that would be, as of today, they would be taking that lamb in their household for a week. They would get comfortable with that lamb. They would play with that lamb. They would take care of that lamb. But then when Passover came, that lamb that they knew, and we're to know the Lamb of God. But thank God we don't have to go pick. We got the unblemished lamb, like I said, Jesus. He's walked perfectly upon this earth without sin. And so here is